Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. A Suncoast business owner protests an upcoming pet sale ban. And is there a coffee conspiracy at Starbucks? We'll discuss.
I'm celebrity makeup artist Mickey Williams, and cooler and drier air is right around the corner, and it can really dull your complexion. Today, I brought you a great new home solution so you can keep your glow.
I'm Bo Beth. Many people aren't aware that there's a world-class gymnastic training facility right here on the Suncoast. They even have an Olympic championship coach, and she's here today.
And I'm Linda Carson. It's another big honor for the Sarasota Ballet as they get ready to perform a unique show. And they brought the stunning costumes to show us. All that and more right now in Suncoast View.
Yay!
I almost did it again.
Welcome to the show, and welcome back to our traveling friend, Mickey Williams. Social media tells me you've been on and off planes a lot.
Yes, I have.
You tired?
Everywhere. East Coast, West Coast, yes, I'm exhausted. But I'm just so happy because I'm going to be here for 3 days, and it's not like...
Three days.
Every day is a different city for what I do, so it's been like, but I'm psyched. I mean...
You look so good for all that traveling.
Because I am such a good makeup artist, Linda. I am such a good
makeup artist.
She knows
what concealer to use to cover the bags.
Spackle. I know what spackle to get. That's what it is. So, yeah.
That is great. Well, we are glad you are here. We're going to have a lot of fun, and we always do with Mickey. And actually, there's some excitement outside the studio right now, and I promise it's not because of anything we've done wrong. The fire department is here. They are busy trimming the tree, but they are also going to be showing us what can go wrong with your Christmas decorations. And it can go wrong in a big way. Things go ablaze quickly. So you have
to take a turn for the worst.
You have to be extra careful.
Go back again and redo it.
Well, and I have been accused at my house of being obsessive about the tree drying out because we had Troy's Tropics in here talking about how if you feel the end of your branches and the needles go all over, your tree is dead. Yeah, well, mine came home like that. Mm. So I'm convinced now. And
it's not
drinking water, and I'm very, very nervous.
Good sign.
No, it's
you
not a good sign.
It.
I need to do something with it.
You could have missed her and just missed it.
I'm going to ask the fire department if that will help.
Two dogs, and you have to now make sure a tree drinks.
Right.
what do you take on, lady?
I'm drinking. The tree is not. See, that's the problem we seem to be having in my house.
Maybe a little wine in the watering can.
It'll be fine.
It'll be okay.
I am concerned about it catching fire, so we will talk to the fire department about that. But first, we want to head to the kitchen where Lawrence from Stottlemyre's is with us today. What are we making?
Today we're going to be doing a coconut almond crusted shrimp with a smoky citrus reduction.
Mm. Oh, that sounds fabulous. Tis the season for citrus, of course, here in the Sunshine State and Stottlemyre's. Of course, some of the great fried chicken and now fried shrimp that we'll get to give a try.
I like it.
Sounds
nice
good.
Smells bacon.
Yes, and I think there's bacon involved somewhere because if you could smell what we were smelling, you'd be as hungry as we now are. So it smells great in here, that's for sure. Mickey, since I do stalk you on social media,
no.
We want to, since you proclaimed what a great makeup artist you are, can we show some of your behind-the-scenes tricks? Do you know why she looks rested?
Oh, yeah.
Because she spackles it on as she travels.
This is actually one of the coolest. I went to an event, and it was for Exuviance, which we're going to talk about later in the show, which is just this amazing glycolic company. But when I got there, they were like, what is your favorite product in the line? I'm like, well, first of all, it's the peel, but also I take this bubble bath mask. And it's an oxygenating mask. And first it tingles, but it pulls all that makeup out of your skin. And it just is so yummy.
I like that idea.
And then when it gets all white like that, but when it goes clear, you rinse your face. But at that point, I'm in the bathtub. I'm like, So it is. It's really yummy. Yeah.
Well, I do think it's funny that you post the pictures of yourself like that, which is great, because that's your job, obviously.
Yeah.
You look so much better.
We definitely would not do that.
Thanks, Linda. Yeah. Did you hear what she just said? She's like, well, it makes you look so much better when you're like this.
Maybe we should try that.
We appreciate her makeup.
Well,
those ugly pictures will look pretty later.
Oh, my goodness. Is that ugly?
No, not at all. Not at all.
Down,
but we know you've had a tough few weeks on the road, and it's amazing that you come and look as amazing as you do.
You're beautiful all the time.
We're ready to get your tricks.
I'm playing with you. You can totally call me out on that one. It's fine.
It's all good. All right, it is time for our first hot topic, and it is not good for a local Suncoast business owner. Selling animals in local pet stores is about to be against the law. An ordinance banning the sale of commercially bred animals is set set to go into effect next month. Now the owner of a local pet store, Petland, is suing the county in an effort to save his business. Now the ban is an attempt to ban operations like puppy mills, which sell animals in bulk at reduced prices to stores. But what do you think? Do you agree with the owner who is trying to save his business?
This is hard because no one ever wants to have to support a puppy mill, because that the whole idea behind that is wrong. But you don't want to hinder another business, so there has to be an in between where maybe you can see where the company is buying their puppies from, because sometimes they're not buying them from mills.
Exactly.
Yeah. If he can prove that the puppies are being well bred, well taken care of, then I think there's still a business for him out there. Maybe it doesn't have to go through the breeders that are doing the wrong thing.
Yes. But if the ordinance passes and says no live animal sales from commercially bred, puppy mill are a legit business. It's not happening. So, yeah, I mean, there's definitely a problem.
I don't know if that's even legal. Can you do that?
They are. And a lot of other people have. I did a little research on this, too, and this is very in vogue right now because obviously puppy mills are a horrible thing. So in an effort to reduce the bad, they're just cutting out all of it in many, many different cities and jurisdictions all across the country.
Yeah. It will mean fewer people have pets. Because that's where most people get their pets, I guess.
Well, I don't know about most, but I think you have to work harder. You'll have to go to a breeder yourself or rescue.
See, yeah, but I think the idea is to bring change in the breeding industry because you don't want them just to be just breeding for just the purpose of breeding.
And
you
know, the dogs
want
the strong.
You want the dog to be able to be taken care of. You want them to be in good conditions and, you know, actually experience like love. A lot of those animals don't.
Yeah, I think it's a really good idea. And the reason why I think it's a great idea is because if you were educated as to where your puppy came from, the person who was producing or breeding your puppy would have to clean up their establishment. Yeah. They would have to do everything. So when you're going to like the middleman, Petland, what's happening is that you never know where that puppy came from. So it's going to make the breeders step it up, and they're going to just be breeding, and people are going to have to go to their facility to see it. Sure, they could have a place like off in the woods, but at least you would know who your breeder is, where this came from, and you would be more aligned. I mean, it's horrible what they're doing, and it's just terrible, but it will increase the rescue, which is unbelievable. We're doing it in New York, so it's just something that, you know, but then it's at the same time, you're like, where does this extend to? It's all live animals. It's fish. It's everything, right? So the company, these bigger chain stores you're just going to see are going to go down. So
right, and unfortunately, some small business owners will as well. I think that is the sad casualty of that. Well, you can now fly direct commercially from Tampa to Havana, but this increased tourism may not be all good for Cuba. The record arrival of 3.5 million visitors last year is causing a surging demand on food in Cuba, so much so that many locals now can't get some very basic staple items, or they can't afford them. Cuba's food supplies, especially from agriculture, simply do not match the increased appetite for tourism, and private restaurants get first dibs on things like produce, leaving state-run market shelves bare. Knowing this, would it keep you from going?
No.
Yeah, I want to go to Cuba because I want to see what it's like, not because of the food.
Yeah.
Well, but you're going to eat while you're there, and if you eat while you're there, that means locals may not.
Oh, I
see what I'm saying?
Locals' food. Maybe
they only have so much food, and if this many people come visit, their food supply goes there.
Import it from here.
I don't think they can afford that.
Well,
and we have embargoes anyway.
Yeah. If they
we're still under embargoes.
They can import it from somewhere else.
Yeah,
but it's not happening. And the problem is the locals are hungry.
Yeah.
Oh, we don't want to do that.
Yeah.
There was an interesting blog about this about a year ago, and I think we all read about it at the time. And it was this lady said, you know, everyone was saying, you got to go to Cuba before Cuba is destroyed by all the tourism and everything. And she's like, no, you're only going to be giving to my economy, and it's going to force my economy to my family's economy to eventually make changes. And that's what she was saying. So she said, you know, here's all this Cuban coffee that everybody raves about. Well, the locals don't get the Cuban coffee. It's mostly sawdust, and we just get a portion of it. So she said, if you make our economy keep shifting over and making changes, then eventually it will trickle down to the people. If that's true, I don't know.
I agree with her. I feel like when there's demand, people meet that demand. So if they don't have food, there's going to be some sort of change that will come about to create that food for
which
them.
Would be great, because they need the change. But right now, I think they're in this in-between. And this was a New York Times article, and I found it fascinating, where things like onions, peppers, avocados, you know, key staples in their agriculture and in their culture of cooking, you know, they've only been able to grow so many of them.
Right,
so right now, they're going to the resorts and they're going to the private restaurants because the tourists.
So now there's and now there's a demand for more farmers. So and people are going to get jobs. So there are going to be more farmers out there producing more and producing more.
We can
hope so. I think it's only going to be a good thing. Yes. They may be short this farming season, but next farming season they're going to
plant more. They'll find the
good attitude,
and that'll be jobs.
And then we can have something to eat when we go.
Look at Brazil. What happened to Brazil? The starving children, all of those children that were there, they would come and beg the tourists for food, for money, for everything, and it ruined their tourism. So they had this whole thing where they were getting the kids off the street. So hopefully this will, you know, if crime rises in Cuba, then we're going to see that hopefully they'll make changes.
Yeah. All right, well, let's hope in the interim, too, that everyone gets
that
what they need.
Jobs, and then they can buy
absolutely.
Their own food.
Well, we go to Starbucks a lot here, of course, and part of the Starbucks experience and their business plan is the barista asks you for your name so they can put it on your cup. Have you ever noticed even the simplest names seem to get messed up? Some smell conspiracy with their coffee. So a YouTuber conducted a fun social experiment at just how often a simple name like Molly is misspelled. So they concluded that Starbucks actually does this on purpose so that the customers post the crazy misspellings on social media and Starbucks gets more free publicity. Do you believe this?
I think that's so
They smart. Misspell my that's name ridiculous. Because my name is unique. I don't think it's a conspiracy.
Everybody well, in your case, I'm sure they do misspell
Have you
your name.
Ever bought a cup of coffee at Starbucks because you saw a picture of a name spelled wrong?
Yeah, but publicity is publicity, right? I mean,
it doesn't make me want coffee to see somebody's name spelled wrong.
Then again, they have publicity over everything. Their cups is a controversy. Their this is a controversy. Whatever flavors.
The spelling is not doing it for them. No.
Everyone thinks I say my name is Nikki, not Mickey, so I'm always messed up. They always write Nikki on my cup.
They write Robert on mine.
Really?
I am definitely not a Robert.
Bo Beth goes into Robert?
Yep.
Yeah, you're definitely one of those people they want to post a picture. Yeah, 100%. With your photo right next to it. Be like, is this a Robert?
Oh, that's very funny. I wanted to show you one of my favorite holiday cards that I've seen so far this season. Holidays, of course, very tough for military families, especially if a loved one is deployed overseas. Brandon Sistrunk is a staff sergeant in the Air Force. He's deployed in Iraq right now. So his wife and kids created a Christmas picture and digitally added him to the picture. When his wife posted this online, obviously, it got tons of attention. I love how she did this. She even got the kids to look. And obviously, he was then photoshopped in.
That's how horrible war is, that it takes people away from their families.
It's just a good reminder of the sacrifice people are making and the, you know, the
so
sadness that families
live.
Feel on the holidays. It's hard to have somebody gone, especially in harm's way.
And on my Christmas cards, you guys are on there.
And we're not photoshopped. She sits with us every day.
Are you serious? I made your Christmas card?
Did
you send me one?
I
Linda. I made Linda's Christmas
card. I only got the Christmas cards. I didn't send them.
Oh, good. Good. You were making me feel very bad. I haven't done that yet either, but they're on the counter, people. Hey, in honor of Rogue One opening in theaters tonight, here's a battle scene you won't see in the movie. Look what happens when a toy Yoda takes on two French bulldogs. I got to tell you, these dogs hang in pretty tough, but Yoda does stand his own. Isn't that great? Stay tuned for a sequel.
A great gift for your dog.
I know, I love that.
Those dogs are probably mortified.
That's very fun. And of course, lots of people in line tonight for the big movie opening.
Oh, tonight's it.
Like our producer, Matt.
Yes, we actually are short a person today because the movie's opening.
And he had to rest up before the all-nighter tonight.
Yeah, I'm serious. Funny. That's where producer Matt is today. We're going to check in with our happy hour forecast. And when we come back, it is time to talk holiday tree safety.
Good afternoon. I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan with your happy hour forecast. A weak cold front has made its way through the Suncoast and drier air is settling in. So not much of a chance for fog tonight. It will be clear and a little bit cooler. The dew point temperatures have been dropping. They've been in the mid 60s now into the upper 50s. Winds are out of the northwest now at 9, bringing in some of that slightly cooler air. The dew point temperature always tells a story and looks like lows tonight will be in the 50s as opposed to the mid 60s that we've been experiencing as of late. And you can see from the satellite review showing pretty quiet conditions over the southeast. There are some clouds out into the Gulf, well off into the Gulf, but the showers associated with the front really fell apart as they made their way through the Suncoast. The evening planner looks like this. Through this evening, temperatures will be in the low 60s by 11 o'clock as opposed to the upper 60s to low 70s that we've been experiencing. So slightly cooler. The front not doing all that much in terms of dropping temperatures significantly. We'll have much more on the forecast for the weekend coming up at 5. See you then.
The holiday season is a time for fun and festivities, but it is also a time for fires. Each year, Christmas trees are to blame for hundreds of home fires and cost more than $16 million in property damage. Ashley Lesby from the Sarasota Fire Department is here to tell us how we can prevent that from happening to us. Welcome, Ashley.
Hello.
Well, it's that time of year. People are putting up decorations, putting up trees. So what can we do to keep our Christmas trees safe?
There's lots of things you can do for your Christmas tree. It all starts when you first pick it out. I believe, as you said earlier, you
picked
it out. That was partially dead.
It's so hard.
You want to make sure that you pick out a good green Christmas tree, one that's not already half dead. And then you want to water it daily and make sure that your lights do not have any frays in them or anything like that. Because actually, a quarter of home Christmas tree fires start from electrical issues.
That's definitely not good. Well, you actually brought us a great example of how things can just go wrong very quickly. So we're going to take a look outside and kind of walk me through what is happening when, you know, what are we looking at?
Now, the first Christmas tree that is on fire right now, this one is a little more greener than our next one. So you can see it's still, even though it's green, it still is going to go up fairly quickly.
Man. Yeah, those flames are hot.
That's quite a fire.
If that were in a house, that would be
That's your roof.
Terrible. Yes. Oh my.
Yeah.
And do all trees ignite to that extent? I mean, is that just because of the amount of wood in there?
Partially, yes, but it starts out slow and then it gets bigger. And this one, you'll see, this one has not been watered for the last week and a half, and it's a little dead. And then obviously when you decorate, sometimes you buy decorations that are not flame resistant, and they obviously add to it. As you can see, this one has more of a black smoke from it. It's because of what's burning.
Okay. Like the plastics.
The presents are burning.
And the presents are burning too.
It seems like this one went up quicker.
It does, because if you don't water it daily, then your tree is dead, and dead trees catch fire a lot quicker than one if you're watering it daily.
Well, what should we do to keep our trees safe?
Okay. Well, there's lots of things, so we'll start off with you want to make sure that you water your tree daily. You want to keep it away from a heat source. Make sure you do not block any exits. And then I don't think this is something we do nowadays, but back in the day, people used to use actual candles to decorate their tree. Ooh. So you don't want to use live candles or lit candles at all to decorate your tree. And then before you leave your house or before you go to bed, you want to make sure that you shut all your Christmas lights off.
So even the lights now, you know, I remember growing up, the lights actually used to be hot to the touch. Yeah. So it was obvious they could cause a problem. But today's lights are completely cool. So there's still a risk with leaving it on?
There is, because what happens is that, did you know that you can only put so many lights together?
No, I didn't.
In a string?
I thought I brought that.
I'm scared to know what it is.
So depending on what kind of Christmas lights you get, if you put too many strands together, you can blow the circuit of it and they can cause electrical fire.
Okay.
And if there's any exposed wiring, as you can see on these ones, I don't know if you can
see. Oh, these are horrible.
But if there's any exposed wiring or anything like that, that can also cause an issue as well. So you want to make sure that you don't have any wire showing at all. Everything is in good order.
Because we store these year after year after year.
But what are some things we should do when we're thinking about decorations? Because I feel like, you know, when you're picking them out, you're not really thinking that this is flammable. You're thinking it's pretty.
Most of the ones nowadays do have a flame resistant on them. So that's something just to look. You can look on the back of all of them and it'll tell you what it is. You want to make sure that you keep candles away from all your decorations. And then you can actually get candles now that have are battery operated that are LED, so you don't have to use a live candle now. And then when you are going through your lights, I mean, this is a great time for when you're taking your decorations down this year, is to check the lights as you're going through, seeing if they need to be replaced. And then when you're hanging them up outside, use plastic clips. Do not hammer a nail in them, because obviously if you're hammering a nail or using a staple gun, which people use, that can cause an issue as well.
Because you could pierce it? Is that the concern? Okay.
And then we don't recommend extension cords. We recommend using something with a breaker, so that way if you overload it, it'll pop the breaker.
And not the whole house.
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, do you see actual increase in calls this time of year?
We do. Typically during any holiday season, there's an increase in calls, and I think we just get so busy. We don't think about the minor things, you know, and you're trying to entertain people, and you're not in your daily routine, so there are more incidences during the holidays.
I've covered some of those when people left candles sitting around, then somebody walked through and threw their house coat over the candle.
Yeah. Well, candles are scary. I'll be honest. The closest call we ever had was due to a candle because, as you mentioned, I had it too close to a decoration. Part of the decoration melted. It landed in the candle, and it flared up.
Yeah.
And, you know, we had live greens everywhere. It was,
you guys aren't helping me put on a tree.
No. I mean, seriously, I'm careful. I think I'm educated, and I would not have thought that having a candle next to a decoration would have caused that kind of
problem. I set one on a glass shelf. There was another glass shelf above it. It melted the glass shelf above it, which fell through, which fell on the floor, and almost started a fire on the floor.
Well, this kind of brings up another idea. You have a smoke alarm.
Yes.
Is that something that we need to make sure we're checking this time of year to make sure they're, you know, we're safe?
You should have, everyone should, if you had a battery operated one, you should have changed the batteries when you changed the clock. But this is a great time when you go home and check them to make sure that they're still working properly. So,
all right, and I guess the takeaway is check your smoke alarm. Don't get a dead tree like Stephanie.
And
use battery candles.
And check your extension if there's any open wires. We don't want to do that. Look, I'm prepared. All I have to do now is get a tree.
Perfect.
All right, well, thank you, Ashley. Now, if you guys want to get more information or any tips, you want to go to Sarasota County Fire Department's website. You're just going to visit scgov.net, and they have all of the details for you. Now, coming up, Mickey has some details for us on how we can look young and beautiful. We'll be right back.
If you want 24/7 access to ABC7's breaking news stories, weather forecasts, traffic alerts, health reports, Suncoast View, and more ABC7 programming, now there's good news. Introducing the free ABC7 channel on Amazon Fire TV. Your 24/7 access to ABC7. Just search ABC7 on the streaming device and download the free ABC7 channel app. Or if you don't have an Amazon Fire TV, you can get one at Amazon.com.
When caring for my wife alone became too much for me, I called my long-term care insurance company to get help from Granny Nannies. Now the most wonderful nurses help me with her care.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse. Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking, and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Are you losing hope? You can recover and get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares.
Call 1-800-764-8708. That's 1-800-764-8708.
Don't miss the 19th annual Thunder by the Bay Motorcycle Festival, January 5th through the 8th, to benefit Suncoast Charities for Children. This year's festival welcomes special guest Blue Oyster Cult to the premier sports campus at Lakewood Ranch on January 8th at 4 p.m. Admission is free. Festival events include a sporting clay tournament, kickoff party, welcome thunder event, cruise for cash charity motorcycle ride, and a two-day rockin' and riding at the ranch festival featuring vendors, live music, a taste of thunder area, and more. VIP tickets are available. For tickets and info, visit thunderbythebay.org.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Welcome back. Even here on the Suncoast, we battle this cooler, drier air that starts to set in over the winter, and it's really hard on our skin. So we asked our beauty expert, Nikki Williams, how to keep us glowing right through the drier seasons, and you have a new product to tell us about.
I do, and we talked about the mask earlier, I know, but this brand is really incredible because what they're doing is they're bringing kind of like, well, they're bringing glycolic acid to the forefront, and they're also doing these incredible products that are just do-it-yourself. You don't have to go to the doctor's office.
Oh, that's so good.
So this one right here is the Exuviance Performance Peel. It's AP25, and I just want to show you the before and afters of these, just so that you get an idea of how incredible this product is. So first off, look at this. Now, what this is doing is it's basically expertly exfoliating skin with a 25% blend of alpha and polyhydroxy acids. Okay, hydroxy acids.
Yeah, I definitely
look at
can
the
see
pores
the
there. What you're seeing is it's removing dull, like dead surface layers, but it's also going to reveal more radiant skin. It's a smoother complexion. You're also going to have a more even complexion. It's diminishing those fine lines and wrinkles. But what's really incredible about it is it improves clarity. But oh my goodness, pore size.
Woo!
This is something that we see that we've never been able to see something like that. So look at this. Look at the smoothness. Look at the color of the skin. All of those are incredible. And we've only been able to see these kind of results in a doctor's office before. You didn't see this with something that, you know, you go into the doctor's office, you get one peel, you can't really go outside for a while. What's beautiful about this product is that you do it twice a week. So here's how you use it, okay? You take your step one, and it's this little kind of like little pad right here.
Hold it up higher so we can see it.
There's your step one, and it's just this nice little pad.
Oh, so it's like a little wipe.
How
super
easy
is that?
You rub this over your face twice a week, right? You wait 10 minutes, and then you use this pad, step two, and this is the neutralizer. It'll stop the product.
Oh.
So it's very safe, but it's like expertly exfoliate. So you're going to be doing this two times a week.
How
for six
easy.
Weeks, it's the easiest thing.
So no creams, no sit around and dry with a mask. Wow, okay,
it's
that's
that
pretty neat.
Easy. I mean, you can do that. You can go have your cup of coffee, you can do whatever, and you're seeing the results are out of this world. And what's incredible about it is, like I said, it's not at a doctor's office. You can go right to an Ulta, pick it up. It's $77.
Wow.
It's unbelievable.
So way less expensive.
6 weeks supply.
And I don't have craters in my face anymore. This is an excellent idea.
I think that that's one of the things that we really see. We see like one appeal that will address basically like, you know, pore size, or it'll address fine lines and wrinkles. What's really amazing, look at these results. It's really clearing up everything.
It does.
And
both.
It's because it has that blend, which when they blend these two acids together, it gives it like a really incredible kind of professional results. Because normally you can't go very high with the percentage of acid that you have in your products. But because they're putting these two blends together, the alpha and the poly hydroxy acids together, you're really seeing these just work hand in hand. And again, this company, like, it's the same one that I was wearing in the picture that you were showing, the oxygen mask. They really, it's kind of like, it's really bringing that do-it-yourself professional treatment at home.
I have a question. So it's called a peel, and I usually shy away from anything called a peel just because obviously we work on TV every day. I don't want to be shedding layers and layers of skin. How much peeling will I have?
It's going to vary to each person depending upon what your skin is like. Definitely if you're, you know, super, super sensitive, you might have a little bit more redness, but I'm incredibly sensitive. I had zero peel, but I also exfoliate daily. So I will use a brush the next day, or I will use kind of like a cloth to clean my face. I only found myself just getting a little tiny bit of flakiness around my nose, like what I call my muzzle area.
Right.
But I get that when I wash, I don't put the right moisturizer on.
Right. So no reason not to use it during the week and then go about our day.
Absolutely. And it's twice a week. So just maintain your normal skincare and make sure you keep your skin, you know, moisturized, and this, especially this winter weather. And you're gonna see incredible results. The results are really impressive.
Well, we love these professional home solutions.
Oh,
so we don't have to go to doctor's offices, and we can treat and look younger and brighter at home. So
and
thank you, Mickey. Great find. You can find this at Ulta, or you can also go to exuviance.com. Coming up next, the Sarasota Ballet is here to showcase a new program and some stunning costumes. Stay with us.
Christmas traditions by Luxart Silks, where more is merrier. Make your holidays sparkle with style. Browse our amazing showroom, cute collectible cottages, and beautiful Christmas displays. Find the inspiration, selection, and quality you need to deck the halls merry and bright. Christmas traditions also features the area's largest selection of quality pre-lit Christmas trees, every size, shape, and color, and plenty of decorations to make your home shine for the holidays. Christmas traditions by Luxart Silks, where more is merrier. Visit us on New 301, just a quarter mile north of University Parkway.
Selling your home? Insist on a 3D showcase tour from Gulf Shores Realty. Virtual tours are flat and boring and look more like a slideshow than a tour. A 3D tour from Gulf Shores Realty is like actually walking through the home without the drive. Get instant access to your next home from any device. Multiple views give homebuyers a perspective like no other. For a limited time, mention ABC7 and Gulf Shores Realty will provide a complimentary 3D tour with your new listing.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
And so the best that I can do is pray. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. luck if you've ever been a lady to begin with. Luck, be a lady tonight. Luck, let a gentleman sing.
Rich finishes, beautiful colors, and over 1,000 different fabrics and leathers to choose from. With Bassett Custom Furniture at Bacon's Furniture and Bedding. Get a quality-built Bassett Queen Sleeper with your choice of innerspring, gel, or Airdream mattress. Starting at only $9.99. Come in today, and we'll guarantee your Bassett Custom Furniture will be shipped before the holidays. With our complimentary design service, start designing, start loving. Only at Bacon's Furniture and Bedding in Port Charlotte. Nobody beats Bacon's.
Sarasota, we're uncorking something special at Michael's Wine Cellar and Tasting Room. Shop in a relaxed atmosphere with our wine specialists. You'll find 1,000 international wines, 200 under $20. National brand and boutique liquors at competitive pricing. Handcrafted beers. Stop by Michael's Wine Cellar and Tasting Room today and let us show you something exceptional.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. Lawrence is in the kitchen from Stottlemyre's today. And Lawrence, we were just having a very disturbing conversation, the girls and I, about preparing shrimp to cook. Tell us the whole process and that vein thing. We have to take it out, really?
Yeah, you definitely want to remove the vein. It's not that big of a deal. Nice paring knife. You want to take the legs off first. Just twist and pull. They come right off nice, neatly. And then one nice cut along the back side of the shrimp all the way down to approximately the tail. And that little dark line, you just want to get that out of there. It's where most shrimp gets its grittiness from. It's that. It's little bits of sand. It's salt. It's pretty much everything that's in the ocean. So
all
you get
right.
that out, your shrimp will taste a lot better. Or you can buy them pre-done like that from your local deli.
All right, I won't tell my family I don't usually do that. So now I've learned I'd rather eat yours. We'll see you in the kitchen in a little bit. Linda?
In August, the U.S. women's gymnastics team won a record 9 medals at the Rio Olympics. They were led by superstar Simone Biles. And now Simone's coach for more than a decade, Amy Borman, has relocated here to the Suncoast. Amy, we are so thrilled that you're here.
Thank you for
now,
having me.
Now, you're with Evo Athletics?
Yes.
Oh, we've heard a lot about that place. Tell us what brought you here.
Well, honestly, I've wanted to move to Florida for a long time, and it became this opportunity to work with somebody that I really admire, and our coaching philosophies really matched up. And he was in the process of building this incredible facility, and all the pieces just came together. My husband got a dream job. My kids were thrilled to move by the beach, and all the pieces just fell into place.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now, Evo's was built just for gymnastics, and it's the ultra training facility, right?
It is fantastic for gymnastics. We have all kinds of free foam pits and trampolines, and you know, our resi pits provide a little bit harder landing. And as you can see, you know, all of the kids are able to train upper level skills, and with our experience in coaching, that helps. But we also provide other programs besides gymnastics. We have a great cheer program. We have an amazing Ninja Warrior course that we'd really love people to come out and see. And then in our other facility, we actually also have volleyball, and we're interested in adding other sports as we continue on.
There's the Ninja Warrior
yes,
course.
Look
that,
at that
is not easy to do. Oh my goodness.
It looks impossible
strong.
To do to me. Now, a lot of your students came with you from Houston, right?
I did.
Families
have a few.
Moved here.
Yes, I did have a few students that moved with me because they really like the philosophy that I provide in training. And, you know, to me, it's about making sure that kids grow up being happy, healthy kids. And gymnastics is just something they do. It's not something they're going to be able to do their whole lives, but they're learning great life lessons by being a gymnast and learning time management and just about having pride in what you do and pride in yourself.
Along with that, some of your students learned how to be the best gymnastics
yes.
in the world.
Yes.
In the world. And so what was it like coaching kids like that, the Olympic stars?
Well, you know, Simone didn't start out as an Olympic star. You know, she was nurtured through the process. Her family unit was fantastic, and they trusted in me to develop her as a gymnast, and they were just supportive parents at home. So with that, you know, and Simone always had the choice, you can do this or not do this.
Oh.
If you do it, you know, her parents always said, be the best Simone you can be, but there was never any pressure put along with that. So our philosophies really came in in tune with each other. And then at the Olympics, you know, people say, well, was it this huge, amazing thing? Yes, it was. I had to tell myself, don't look at the Olympic rings because you'll get a little, you know, gets a little beklempt about it.
Yeah.
But in reality, the girls were so prepared and the coaching staff was so prepared that we went out there with the confidence knowing that we could bring home the gold medal.
Well, you know, even beyond that, is it kind of surreal to know that the skills that you were passing on or teaching these people are then becoming the championships? Like, whatever you taught them helped them get that ring.
Yes, absolutely. It has to do with not only in their gymnastics, because yes, through that process and every day and the training and the persistence and all of that, but if you look at these young women now out in their media lives mm-hmm. and their professional lives outside of gymnastics, you see how confident they are and how they have the belief in themselves. And to me, as a coach, that's the most important thing. You know, yeah, I am so proud that I have an Olympic ring, but above and beyond that, it's about what kind of people they become.
Well, and
you know, if I could do those things, I would be an amazing person. I would be confident if I could do those things.
Your philosophy is refreshingly different, though, because for so many years we heard about, you know, the strict gymnast coach mm-hmm. and how everything was this and this and this, and it was hard on the girls, and it was a very difficult lifestyle. You know, how do the girls respond to having a little bit more of a well-rounded attitude?
Well, I like that you say well-rounded, because that's really what I try to do. I try to make sure that they understand that family is important. To me, it's family, school, then gymnastics. Mm. That's it. But they understand that they have to be dedicated to gymnastics. If they miss a lot of practices, or if their body isn't healthy for practice, it's going to set them back even further. Mm-hmm. So they make the sacrifices. So it's not to say that an elite gymnast has an easy life, because they do miss out on homecoming, they do miss out mm-hmm. on prom. They miss those things, but they're doing it by their own choice,
right?
With
not
me as their coach.
And a lot of times they probably miss school in terms of the normal social environment, because
yes.
I know when they're competing and traveling, you're homeschooling, you're studying, you're virtual schooling.
Exactly.
It's
yes.
a very different
it's
life.
It's very different. So they also miss that social aspect of having those friendships in school. All uh-huh. of their friendships are at gym, mm. and so it is a challenge for them.
Now, you've got a holiday day camp coming up.
Yes, we do. We've got it. I don't remember the exact times right now, but I know we're offering it all day during the weeks that Sarasota and Manatee are out of school.
Ah.
And so we're offering all kinds of activities with the gymnastics, cheer, ninja, volleyball. Everything is going to be available. So
you
we're
don't have to
about
be
that.
An Olympic star.
No, you do not. You just have to want to come and have some fun.
So Evo Athletics is open to the public, even if I'm not training
yes,
as an elite gymnast.
Even us, like adults,
yes,
can go.
Yes, okay. absolutely. And our Ninja Warrior course is actually open most hours. You just have to call ahead and say, hey, I'd like to come in and try out your Ninja Warrior course. And
fun.
We have, honestly, the other day we had a family of kids, or a family ranging from, I want to say the youngest was 8, and the parents, and I think even grandma came to watch.
Oh, wow.
That
sounds like so much fun.
It is.
We're so excited to have you here. And to find out more about the camp and more about their programs, you can go to evoathletics.com. That's EVO. EvoAthletics.com. Next, the Sarasota Ballet has a brand new program that you'll see this weekend. We're going to talk to them in just a minute.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights.
Types of timber, cuts of meat, cooking times, temperatures, rubs, seasonings, sauces. You name it, they know it. That's what makes them who they are. Sonny's Pitmasters. And proud of it. Come get some baby back ribs at Sonny's Barbecue. On their own or paired with favorites like jalapeno cheddar hot links or pulled or sliced pork plus two sides and bread. Sonny's Barbecue. Local Pitmasters since 68.
Studios on Florida Suncoast. This is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at 5 o'clock. A tragic accident at a Bradenton home. A longtime city councilman's wife dies while parking her car. Police explain how it happened. And a new high-flying business at Venice Municipal Airport when skydivers will take the jump down to the airport. Now let's get a check on our weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob.
Well, a good day for that, Scott. We had a cold front move through. The cold front bringing some cooler air, drier air, so we're not going to see the problem with fog that we've had over the past several nights, at least not tonight. 72 degrees, dew point is what's dropped. It's down to 58 degrees now, and that'll make our overnight low temperature much cooler than it has been. Winds are out of the northwest, indicating that front is now by us. You can see a few showers associated with down to South Florida, but for us, high and dry, pretty clear here. We still have some fog to deal with. We'll let you know when that fog will be back, coming up today at 5.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5.
I owed the IRS $10,000.
I owed the IRS $20,000.
The IRS garnished my wages.
They put a lien on my house.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency in the world. They do not give up until you pay.
I couldn't sleep. We were being audited. I called Tax Solutions Now, and a great big weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I called Tax Solutions Now, and they got the IRS off my back.
Tax Solutions Now had my wage garnishment lifted in 48 hours.
Tax Solutions Now can get you help. Our agents know the rules, can stop the pain, and get you the best deal.
We saved our home and overcame the most powerful collection agency in the world.
We connect you with a team of former IRS agents and tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Time is running out. Call Tax Solutions Now.
Call 1-800-565-7740. That's 1-800-565-7740.
If you have a suspicion for harboring prostate cancer, we have a way of diagnosing by using an exquisite instrument called three-dimensional color flow power Doppler ultrasound. Using this system, we can identify abnormalities within the prostate that you could otherwise never detect. The Dottoli Cancer Center is the only center in the southeastern United States which has this technology. If you have prostate cancer, we will find it.
Welcome back. This is a very special weekend for the Sarasota Ballet. They will present George Balanchine's Jewels, which is a local company, which is very rare for a local company to get to do this, because normally it has to be an international company or a national company with great renown. And here it's going to be at the Sarasota Ballet this weekend. Ian Webb joins us, the executive director.
Good to see you.
How'd you get permission to do this?
I still really can't believe we got permission. I approached the Balanchine Trust, and initially I asked for the single pieces. I asked for rubies first and then emeralds. And when I was asking for emeralds, I said, and who knows, one day we could do the whole thing. And they said, well, one step at a time, Ian. And I asked because I felt I could be that cheeky enough to ask for it, and then was totally shocked when they said we could do it.
But they knew you before. They knew you and Maggie from the Royal Ballet,
right? Yeah, they've been very big supporters, but Jewels is one of the most important things of today, because when you look at a ballet company, you go, oh, it used to be Sleeping Beauty and things like that. But now Jewels is that caliber.
Oh, wow.
And if you think, actually, next in the summer, it'll be the 50th anniversary of Jewels, and it's going to be the Paris Opera going to come to New York and do emeralds, New York City Ballet going to do rubies, and the Bolshoi Ballet are going to do diamonds.
And here you
but
do
here
all
we are,
three.
The whole company.
Doing the whole thing.
That's quite a list to be included in.
It's scary, but exciting.
Yeah.
It's
yes. So. Well, there's a lot of cultural significance here, right, in the choice of the jewels.
Exactly. And it all, basically, he was a genius, without a doubt, both musically, choreographically, and everything. So emeralds is sort of Fauré's music. And it gives that sort of the perfume, the French perfume, real sort of romantic. And then you have rubies, which is Stravinsky, and it's very sort of like jazzy, American jazzy. And then Mr. Balanchine was born in sort of Russia, in Tbilisi, actually, in Georgia. But so diamonds is the big imperial Tchaikovsky music. It's all the thing of the ballet world. So to put the three together, choreographically and everything, but also musically, I think it'd be great just to have a concert and just listen to these, because again, so there's so much going on that it's, as I say, I'm still in shock that we've actually, a company of our size has been allowed to do it.
And they're so careful about how it's passed on.
Yeah. Yeah, so basically we have Sandra Jennings, who worked with New York City Ballet with Mr. Balanchine. So she's come down and said all three. But when we did Emeralds, Emeralds has two principal ladies it was choreographed on. One was Mimi Paul, and one was the great, great ballerina Violette Verdi. And they were both meant to come here, and Mimi Paul did come to coach her section, but unfortunately Violette became ill just days before she was flying here, and sadly did pass away.
Oh, that's so sorry.
You know, very shortly afterwards. But that, so the whole tribute as well is for Violette. So
speaking of the tribute, you actually brought examples of some of the gorgeous costumes.
Oh, yes.
So can you bring some? Oh,
yes,
look
so
at
emeralds.
That. Goodness,
emeralds.
And that's obviously a big part of the presentation since we're talking about jewels.
Yeah. Exactly. So Krajenska was the great designer. And she was sort of, she had her own
beautiful
sort of design things.
Stunning.
And worked very much with Balanchine.
So you always have to have the same costume when you do that?
Yeah, you've
they
got
have
to have,
be exact.
You can't, yeah, you've got to be really, have everything approved. So these all came actually from the National Ballet of Canada.
Oh, wow.
So we hired those in.
That's
amazing. Oh, and to see the jewels sparkle under the lights on stage,
yeah.
That must be amazing.
And rubies, of course.
And rubies.
Beautiful. Tell us about this one.
Well, this is really sort of jazzy. And Patricia McBride, who was one of the great stars in New York City Ballet, when she was asked about it, she said, I'm just a showgirl.
It definitely has a sexier theme rather than the elegance.
Yeah, some American
And with Stravinsky's influence. Music, which is really sort of powerful. And really
showy.
Sort of, yeah, and you hear, when you're close to it, you hear the jewels clashing.
Yeah.
So it all adds more.
And
diamonds. And then diamonds.
It's regal.
Yeah.
Very, very elegant.
Yeah. Yeah, very much so.
So each thing on that costume is approved. It
Absolutely.
Has to be exact.
Every you can't change anything about the choreography, the music is the complete with the Sarasota Orchestra. We have Ormsby Wilkins, who's the conductor, musical director for American Ballet Theatre.
And we're seeing the whole thing this time.
Everything.
We rarely
Everything.
Get to see the whole
yeah.
thing.
Yeah.
And you can see it too, sarasotaballet.org for more information. And Balanchine's Jewels is going to be December 16th and 17th at the Van Wezel. Two nights and one afternoon. You better get your tickets right now. It is lovely. Next, we're going to have our gift guide for the season.
Attention blood clot filter patients. Surgically implanted blood clot filters are potentially life-threatening. Some filters are prone to breaking, resulting in pieces of the filter moving through the body and causing internal bleeding. If you had surgery to implant a blood clot filter, you may be entitled to a cash award, even if you haven't suffered side effects yet. Call the Gold Shield Group now, 888-747-5291, to see if you qualify for a cash award. 888-747-5291.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, A-N-D, services.com.
So many possibilities worth exploring, Minnesota Flooring.
Looking for carpet? Look no further. Minnesota Flooring has Smart Strand carpet as low as $1.79 per square foot. Installed, no add-ons or extras. Unbelievable? Minnesota Flooring can have in-stock carpet installed in your home in 48 hours for as low as $1.99 per square foot. Don't miss these prices. Visit Minnesota Flooring today. Pro Cream by Dr. Anna, known as the facelift in a bottle, is an all-natural anti-aging formula that tightens skin and muscles, making you look younger. It's made in Sarasota with real pearls, Chinese herbs, and no preservatives. Visit our store or at pearlcreambydranna.com.
Kick off the season and find a unique holiday gift at the St. Petersburg Holiday of the Arts. Over 100 artists and thousands of works of contemporary art in photography, glass, sculpture, jewelry, and much more. The third annual St. Petersburg Holiday of the Arts, Saturday and Sunday, December 17 and 18th at South Straw Park in St. Petersburg. Bring your sense of discovery and appreciation of the beautiful at the St. Pete Holiday of the Arts. For more information, visit ParagonArtEvents.com.
They care. They take the time to understand you, take the time to understand your case.
There's no better satisfaction to me than to see a client who is happy because of the job we've done for them.
It's really actually very comforting to know that there's someone that you've heard of and you're getting recommendations about that you can turn to when you have a problem.
I felt like I had a partner in this, and he was going to be by my side.
Our Suncoast View gift guide continues, and this is from a local boutique called Molly's. It is on Stickney Point Road, and they've got a lot of different fun finds. I love the water bottles, and you can get those customized as well. Some really cool stationery products, but my very favorite find is this snowflake Christmas ornament. And maybe this makes me a little mean.
I thought that was a necklace.
Our version of snowflakes is, of course, sand, because we shovel sand. There's sand in the middle here. Siesta Key sand right in the middle of the snowflake. Something sweet maybe for your friends to remember their trips to the beach and to visit you, or also just a way to show everybody how we celebrate winter here on the Suncoast.
Maybe send one to somebody up north.
Maybe you should wait till after the snow storm until it stops being freezing cold there. But anyway, just another great local place. We're all about shopping local to support our Suncoast stores here, Molly's Boutique on Stickney Point Road. Go check it out. All right, we're going to check out the kitchen with our local Stottemeyers. We're headed there next.
ABC 7 News at 7 weeknights.
The official salon of ABC 7.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Haley Wilkes. Here's what we're working on for 5 o'clock. An impressive science fair project at a Sarasota high school, why a sophomore is motivated to find a cure for Alzheimer's disease. Now taking a quick look at Suncoast Traffic Watch, there's an accident in Manatee County. It's on Cortez Road at 17th Street, so you may want to avoid that area. Now let's head over to Bob.
Haley, we've got some good news. No fog problems tonight as a result of a cold front that pushed through earlier today. Our dew point temperature is dropping, so it will be noticeably cooler too to start things off, especially on Friday. Winds have switched around to the northwest now, and they're at 9 miles an hour. You can actually see the front moving through. This is a visible satellite imagery as the clouds kind of progress to the south. That's that wind shift change, and the slightly drier air has indeed moved in, and that's what we'll see overnight with looks like a warming trend to begin over the weekend. Details on that at 5.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5. At ABC 7, it's all about being here for you. ABC 7 News at 7 with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community with a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers. Plus a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC 7 News at 7 weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast.
Sarasota Jungle Gardens invites your family to the Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. Come enjoy dazzling light displays, live entertainment, and pictures with Santa. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style, or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
There are many choices when it comes to AC companies. Our advice? Choose a company that performs employee background checks and is licensed with top manufacturers like Daikin. Daikin offers a 12-year parts and labor limited warranty. For better comfort and value, call Elite Heating and Air.
Alex Karras Lincoln's holiday sales event is here. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKC Sports Utility for $269 per month or a 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury. Winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Sun Coast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41. Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Don't miss Sarasota Jungle Gardens Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. There's joyous music, roasting marshmallows, and festive family activities. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com. Oh,
Merry Christmas.
Welcome back. We're here with Chef Lawrence Hemmer from Stoudemire's. What are you making? It smells so good. I smell bacon.
Bacon. It's Stoudemire's. We start everything with bacon. It's where good Southern home cooking comes from. You start with bacon.
Very awesome.
So today we're going to be doing coconut and almond encrusted fried shrimp. Okay. Anybody can fry shrimp. We're going to get a little creative with a smokehouse smoky citrus reduction dipping sauce.
Wow. Okay. That sounds great. Right, everything I like.
All right. So what do we need to do first?
First thing first.
Frying the bacon.
Fry up your bacon. You want to get good bacon grease in your pan.
Okay. Are we going to use the bacon grease for something else?
The bacon grease is going to be the base for the sauce. It's what everything else is going to cook in is
in
the bacon drippings.
And that's why everything is so good.
Let's put this up a
okay,
bit.
And while you were working earlier, it looks like you'd already done some breading of the shrimp. Tell us about what it's crusted with.
With the shrimp, I hand chopped and crushed up fresh almonds and some smoked almonds just to add a little pop to it. You just dredge it through a seasoned flour, whatever your favorite seasoning is.
Okay.
I use the Stoudemire's basic that we bread everything in.
Okay.
So you then
flour.
Have to put in butter or some sort of thing to make it stick?
I just dredged it after I rinse the shrimp. I dredge it through the flour. Then I put it through an egg wash, just two eggs beaten. And then I roll them through the almonds and the coconut.
Okay.
And then I just set them aside so that they could, you know, be done here.
Good.
It's a little time consuming.
And then I see Mickey's armed with a knife. What are you going to have her do?
She is going to chop up some fresh onion grass for us. And she's also going to...
Onion grass, is that the top of a green onion? What is that?
Good. Actually, onion grass is its own thing. It's actually where chives come from.
Oh. Really?
It's a little bit different. It's a little more mild than
you
an actual green onion.
You need to work on that, Babette.
What? I'm supposed to do something?
The orange.
She was actually
I was just moving
there.
It out of the way so we could see what she was doing.
Which of these should I put together? These?
Okay,
yes, the cornstarch goes into the pineapple juice. Just whisk it because we're going to use that to actually thicken our sauce. But you always have to add cold to hot or hot to cold.
Oh, really? It really did
whisk
matter.
It in or it will just thicken up and it'll clump
I
and it won't
know.
Come out that.
So you always add cold to hot?
Yes, cold to hot or you can go hot to cold.
And does Mickey need to cut the orange as well?
Yes, please.
All right,
I'll give it
pass
back.
That down. I'm going to cut it in half, you said, right?
Yep, just cut
it
in half.
And I'm through with this.
Yep, that is ready.
Now we are
nice,
ready
Mickey,
to go.
You did it.
All right,
that's smelling better and better now.
It is amazing.
Yes,
and I'm standing in front of it.
Oh.
Mm. All right, bacon aside and set it on a plate.
Come on over here.
Okay, here, I can give you one of those.
Over here.
Oh, come on, put it on our side.
Got it over there.
You're not supposed
That's
going to
actually
eat it.
Be chopped up and added back
yes.
into the sauce.
Okay. Do not eat the bacon.
Okay. What? So let's go ahead and make the sauce while we have our bacon fat here.
We got a good hot pan. It's starting to get a little bit of smoke to it. We're going to go ahead and deglaze the pan with some white wine.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow.
We're going to add a cup and a half of orange juice, if you could measure that.
Are you sure about this?
Whoops.
It's labeled. You ought to be all right. Yeah. Do it over the pan so you don't spill.
And we're going to add
That's
some
fresh
That's
not a cup. You got to fill it all the way.
It says a cup. That was a cup.
But you have to fill it to the top for it to
was.
Be a cup. No, it was not.
All right, and that's a little over a half.
Yep, that's
good. So
you
feel better?
But best the eyeball cook.
I do. I don't use a measure. All right, and then what happens next?
Mickey's orange.
Next, when you guys wants to try real hard to juice, get as much juice out of that orange
as you can. Go, Bobeth.
I'm not eating bacon over here or anything. I'm just saying.
That means
I'm not putting my finger over there.
All right,
and let's
get the spices in, Lawrence, because we're coming down to our final minute here.
I took everything as far as measuring everything out ahead of time.
Perfect.
So just tell us what we're dropping.
That's the last. So it matters the order.
All right, so
not particularly other than just that one.
What is this?
Brown sugar, light brown sugar, smoked paprika.
All righty.
Crushed red pepper.
All righty. And Stephanie is eating.
Yep.
Some
just a pinch, not there you go, perfect.
All right, and this is the citrus reduction that goes with our coconut crusted shrimp. A lot of busy hands here in the kitchen. This is all at Stottlemyre's. Also fried chicken. Good half roasted chickens, lots of wonderful things on the menu. But this is where we're headed. Everyone's going to keep on cooking here. Be sure to join Stottlemyre's. They've got a great outdoor patio this time of year. It's a lot of fun to sit outside and enjoy. Mickey, we'll see you tomorrow.
I can't wait.
Thanks for joining us. Lawrence, thanks for the great cooking tips.
Thank you.
Everybody, enjoy the rest of the day. Be sure to take some time and enjoy the Suncoast view. I'm digging in.
Bring me the fried chicken.